And then on Saturday, the buses arrived. We moved out. Oh, if I had a map here, I could show you where we were at. But it was a couple streets, I guess that'd be south of the convention center, along a long stretch. And then had somebody showed up with little cattle guards so we could help channel people and set up little loading stations, for lack of a better word, probably seven or eight of them. Secured those sites, and then people just flowed down the streets on a north to south direction at those locations where we had them set up, ready to load, and tried to, we didn't pat people down, we didn't go that far, but we were trying to confiscate weapons and things like that. Because you're loading onto a bus, and people had large items that you just weren't going to be able to get on a bus. And so for the most part, people, I don't recall any time where anybody gave us too much pushback and said, hey, we're taking this. Because we've tried our best to keep families together. That was a big issue, as you might suspect. There's a bus with 15 seats left on it, and I've got a family of 20 here. Now what? Well, that's okay. Wait right here. The next batch of buses that will come up will hold a whole one for you. And people were, very, very cooperative. The buses arrived on Saturday, I would say around 9 or 10 in the morning, and by 2:30 in the afternoon, it was a ghost town. And that was I would say that day right there was the best day of my military career. Because you really knew that you had helped people that desperately needed it.